Welcome to the MEP Academy. We're going to cover how to calculate GPM of a new chiller evaporator or condenser coil or any new coil or heat exchanger by a field measurement of the actual pressure drop compared to the rated pressure drop of the equipment. In this equation, GPM2 is the actual flow rate that we're going to calculate. It could be for any coil, whether in a chiller, fan coil, or a heat exchanger. So the rated GPM is GPM1 times the square root of pressure drop 2, PD2, which is the actual pressure drop that we are going to measure. This is different than the rated pressure drop, which is PD1. The pressure drop across the chiller's evaporator could be the condenser or a heat exchanger or a fan coil that you're trying to measure. So what will happen to the GPM if the pressure drop increases or decreases? For our example, we're going to take a new chiller that was rated for 600 GPM at 14 feet of pressure drop through its evaporator. So when we go into the field and measure the actual pressure drop, we get 13 feet, not 14 as it was rated. So what is this going to do to our GPM? Now what we're going to do is we're going to take all the known rated conditions of the new piece of equipment, in this example, the evaporator of a chiller, and the actual measured from our field technician, the pressure drop from the field. So here's our formula. All we're going to do is put the known rated values for the evaporator, which is GPM1, the rated GPM is 600, times the square root of the actual measured pressure drop, which came out to be 13 feet. We're going to divide that by the rated pressure drop of 14 feet for our example evaporator. All we have to do at this point is math. So doing the math, we come up with 578 GPM. So our 600 GPM at 14 feet pressure drop rated condition is now only flowing 578 GPM due to the decrease in pressure drop. So a decrease in pressure drop equals a decrease in GPM. Subscribe for additional videos. We will be covering mechanical, electrical, and plumbing estimating, engineering, installation and fabrication best practices for mostly commercial construction and some residential.